we ran half on the sand and half on old A1A, they call it then.
The annual February race at Daytona began in 1948 and ran on the beach for 10 years before moving to its current location. Russ Truelove competed in four of those original 10 battles at the beach, first appearing in 1953.
In that race, they started 136 sportsman modified coupes in the same race.
136.
And the only way we could start them, they could start them, was three abreast lined up all the way up the beach.
Truelove and many other drivers drove their personal cars in the race. And if they crashed, well, finding a way home was quite the challenge.
Going home with my wife, she wanted to know, what are we going to do now? And I said, I don't know, but I'll think of something, because now I've got a wreck.
But not everyone was thinking about how to get home. Meet Mad Marion McDonald. With a nickname like Mad Marion, you can guess how he got it.
I guess by driving like a crazy man.
McDonald looks back at those days with a simple perspective.
Well, it's just ordinary driving right down the beach, like you do still drive, not right now, but you just roll a little bit faster.
Drivers like Russ Truelove and Mad Marion McDonald, who raced during NASCAR's early years, want people to know where beach chairs sit now is where the road to Daytona was originally paved.
I consider it very important that we remember all those that put their footprints in the sand of Daytona.
It's those footprints that'll wipe away with time, but the memories are what NASCAR legends like Truelove and McDonald hope will last for generations to come. In Daytona Beach, Jared Munch, Watch Fox News.